In this lesson, we will learn about files in Python. So what are files? Files are used to store any form of data. So documents, images, web pages, databases, Excel sheets. These are all files. They have a similar structure. And what is it? It is a string of characters that encode some information. And the way they have encoding that information, or the way they have encoded that information, is referred to as the specific file format, which is typically indicated by the extension of the file. So at the end of the file, you would have noticed things like .txt, .doc, .mp3, .png. A Python code is typically has a file format .py. A Java code has a file format typically .java. A PDF is .pdf. So the specific file format indicates the way this file has been encoded, and hence who can use it. Let's look at some functions as to how to use files in Python. So here we have a file. So this is the file test1.txt that we are using in this code. So here we are saying f is equal to open test1.txt. So it's specifying the name of the file we want to open. And here we are saying the mode we want to open it in. So R stands for read, which means this file will only be opened in read mode and we cannot modify it. Next, we are saying data1 is equal to f.read. Now when we say f.read, notice f was the file handle which we got here. So the f here, which we got after open, is referred to as file handle. So when we say f.read, all the contents of the file will be read into f. And then when we say print data1, means all these contents would have been read into data1, which means what will be printed is Android Python. So this is what will get printed on the screen. And f.close, it's important to close all our files. So f.close closes all those file handles that we had created when we opened the file. So this is a complete way of how we would read a file. Let's look at the next. So we are saying it's the same open, but instead of R, we are saying W. W means write. So what does write do? So if the file does not exist, it will create a new file. If the file exists, it will truncate that file. Truncate means, so here this was that file test1.read. So when it truncate means, it will delete all of it in the file. And then when we say f.write perfect Python will be written in this file. So this is the change that will happen to this file test1.txt. And when we say f.close, this file handle will be closed. So when we open in write mode, remember the contents of the previous file get truncated or deleted. Then we have another mode we can open this file in, which is A. A stands for append. So append means that I can now write this file, but its contents will not be deleted. I will write at the end of the file. So now when I say f.write, welcome to EduFact. So welcome to EduFact will be written to the end of this file here. So here we have written welcome to EduFact at the end of this file, and then we have again closed it. So now we have test1.txt, which now looks like perfect Python and welcome to EduFact. Let's look at more ways to or use these files. So here we are saying open test1.txt comma r is the standard one that we use, but here we are saying with and then making the open as f. So what with does is it automatically closes this file once we get out of this indented block. So once we come out of this indented block, the file handle will automatically be closed. So we do not need to remember to close it. So this is a very nice way, and this is the preferred way in which we will use files. So here we have said with open test1.txt in read format as f, and then we are saying data1 is equal to f.read, which means all this content will be read into data1, And when we say print data 1, means this will be printed on the screen. So this is what we would get once we say print data 1. Let's look at another example. So here we are opening the file in the same format with width, but here we are saying data 1 is equal to f.read4. Now what does f.read4 mean? It means read the next 4 characters from where the file handle is. So when we open the file handle is here at the start of the code. So now it will read the first 4 characters, which is PERF. So when we print data 1, what will get printed is PERF. Then it's saying data 2 is equal to f.read6. Where is the file handle? The file handle is sitting here after F, because we had read the rest of the code. Now it will read 6 characters from F. So 6 characters means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So ECT space PY. So notice space is also a character, so it will be read. So hence we will get the, when we print data 2, this will be printed on the screen. ECT space PY. Now when we are saying f.read1 means we are reading one character. So what is the character we will read? Obviously we will read T now. So T will get printed on the screen. So this is the way we can read specific characters on the number of characters we want to read. Remember, we are not doing an f.close. Why? Because we opened it with width. So at the end of this indented block, the file handle will be automatically closed. Let's look at one final example. So here we are declaring a list f data, and now what are we saying? We are opening the file in the same format with if, and now here we are saying for f line in f. Now for f line in f means we are reading all the lines, we are iterating over all the lines in this file f and giving them to the value f line. So exactly how we iterate through the list, we will iterate through this file line by line. And then we are saying f data dot append f line. So the first time we read this file, what will be f line be? F line will get the value perfect Python. So if we look at our, and then when we append it to f data, what will happen? So it will get the value perfect Python. The next time what will happen? The next time it will get the value welcome to EduFit. So this is how our list will become, and when we print f data, this entire list will get printed on the screen. So here we get a way to read a file line by line. So we have now figured out 3 ways of reading the file. We can read all the contents of the file in this fashion, which is f.read without any parameters. Here we read all the contents in the file. We can read the file depending upon the number of characters we want to read. And the third is we can read a file line by line in this fashion. Okay.